to hand over to Dan. So we're going to sing our first hymn together, if you'd like to stand if you're able.
Oh.
Christ is risen.
The world will learn of thy testimony.
Christ is risen.
The spirits of evil are fallen.
Christ is risen.
The angels of God are rejoicing.
Christ is risen.
The tombs of the dead are empty. Christ is risen indeed from the dead. The first of sleepers. Glory and power of his forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated as we come to our time of confession. And we say together, we serve a risen Saviour, yet live as if in chains.
Forgive us, Lord, that we are so hesitant to live the resurrection life.
Forgive us that we fail to show
through word and action the truth that you loved us into your kingdom through the glorious mystery of the cross. Forgive us that there is still fear in our lives that prevents us from achieving our full potential. Draw us close, open our eyes to the glory of the risen Christ, our hearts to the wonder of the cross, and our hands to the service of your kingdom, where you have placed us, that your name might be glorified through our lives. Amen.
God of resurrection, of life, and death, rebirth,
renew our hearts and minds.
God of promise of all beginnings and all endings,
renew our hearts and minds.
God of hope of new growth and harvest,
renew our hearts and minds.
And so we receive God's forgiveness. Lord, the resurrection of your Son has given us new life and renewed hope. Help us to live as new people. Grant us wisdom to know what we must do, the will to want to do it, the courage to undertake it, the perseverance to continue to do it, and the strength to complete it. Amen. And now we listen to God's word. Could we have our readers come forward, please? Oh, sorry, before that, a long time since I've had a service. We have our young people going to their groups, so if we'd like to invite them out, we can pray for them. Fantastic. So, Father God, we just thank you for the joy of having children with us this morning, and we just pray that they and their leaders will be blessed as they study your word together. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. And our first reading is from Acts.
First reading is from Acts chapter 16, verses 9 to 15. During the night, Paul had a vision of a man of Macedonia standing and begging him, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." After Paul had seen the vision, we got ready at once to leave for Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them. From Troas we put out to sea and sailed straight for Samothrace, and the next day on to Neapolis. From there we travelled to Philippi, a Roman colony, the leading city of that district of Macedonia, and we stayed there several days. On the Sabbath, we went outside the city gate to the river, where we expected to find a place of prayer. We sat down and began to speak to the women who had gathered there. One of these, those listening, was a woman named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth from the city of Thyatira, who was a worshipper of God. The Lord opened her heart to respond to Paul's message. When she and the members of her household were baptized, she invited us to her home.
Please stand as we hear the gospel. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
So this reading is John 14, verses 23 to 29. Jesus replied, "If anyone loves me, he will obey my teaching. My Father will love him, and we will come to him and make a home with him. He does not love me. He who does not love me will not obey my teaching. These words you hear are not my own. They belong to the Father who sent me. All this I have spoken while still with you. But the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I've said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as this world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. You heard me say, I'm going away, and I'm coming back to you. If you loved me, you would be glad that I'm going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. I've told you now before it happens, so that when it does happen, you will believe." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. Let's just take that breath again. Let's pray that God will speak to each one of us through his word. Breathing in. Teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. You heard me say, I am going away, and I am coming back to you. If you loved me, you would be glad that I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. I have told you now, before it happens, so that when it does happen, you will believe. It just really felt that I needed to bring that reading into that few more verses to help us to understand what Jesus is actually saying. And I think it makes more sense if we go from verse 18. Thank you, Dorothy. And thank you, Marion, too. I just need to encourage you. You're both great readers. Great readers, so thank you. As is everybody else on the reading list. Great readers, thank you. So, of course, this passage, as we well know it, John always talks about love, doesn't he? I don't know whether you can hear a theme coming through over the past few weeks with different people who have stood here, as I have, and talked about love. And John talks about love a lot. But this is his farewell discourse, as is often called. It's his last conversation with his disciples on the night before his death. And of course, it's a discourse, it's a conversation that's just absolutely full of anxious questions by his disciples about his impending departure. And that made me think about everything has a beginning. Everything. In John's Gospel, go home and check this out, as I have already. In John's Gospel, his very first line is, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. So then, if we go right back to the beginning of our Bibles, right, we see that in the beginning was the Word. Who is the Word? Well, the Word, of course, is Jesus. And then there at the beginning, right on that first page of our Bibles, we also read of the Spirit of God brooding over the waters. Some versions will say hovering over the waters. And I love, because we're in John's Gospel, I love that picture I have of the Holy Spirit hovering over the water, hovering over each one of us. What a very powerful image. Not only, but he doesn't want to just hover over the water, hover over us. And I think sometimes that happens. He's up there somewhere, or the Spirit is up there somewhere. What it wants to do is not hover, but dwell within us, because that's his promise, isn't it? But we have to begin that journey by opening our hearts for that relationship to be open and longing and lasting. And when we open ourselves up, then we can begin to receive him into our homes. Not the houses we live in, these homes. This is, scripture tells us, this is a holy temple where God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit want, long, yearn to dwell. Open the doors of our hearts open the eyes of our hearts, open the ears of our hearts. We have to open up ourselves completely to receive him into our holy temples, because he longs and yearns to dwell within. Everything has a beginning, and it is only with time and prayer and the aid of the Holy Spirit that we can begin to see how God might be working for good, even in the midst of some terrible, horrendous, confusing situations in our lives and in the lives of our community and our world. To keep Jesus in our hearts, we have to take time and prayer. We have to be guided by the Holy Spirit. And if we're not guided by the Holy Spirit, then we should be. In everything we do, as individuals, as a church, everything. Everything is guided by the Holy Spirit. And so, I know some of you will know this, but I think it's worth just bringing this. This is part of my story. In the context of my new beginning, I believe that my heart was opened, right? And I received the Holy Spirit when I was around 8 years old. I believe even in my childish state, that's why we welcome the little children, the Holy Spirit dwelt within me. Because how can you not have the Holy Spirit within you when you're 8, loving church so much that in the morning that you would even go back to sing more songs in the afternoon? Wide is the ocean. Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. And if you're not quite there yet, they were my Sally Army days at the William Booth Memorial Hall, stone's throw from here, really. And I believe that Holy Spirit was brooding, hovering over me and in me. And even at such a young age, life gets in the way. You can't very well stay in St. Anne's and go to William Booth Memorial Hall, Salvation Army on your own. When your family moves up to Clifton, you have to move with them. That's the way it goes. So my Salvation Army days ended there. Everything has to have an end. So when the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, dwells within us, we must cherish it and water our seed of faith. Because if we don't, that soil where my seed of faith dropped, where I really felt the power of the Holy Spirit on my life, lay dormant under the soil. Because there was no going to church, there was no daily prayer to sustain me. There was no reading of my Bible, because I didn't have one. So my family moved to Clifton, so did I. That was the end. Because everything has to have an end. Then, here you go. 32 years later, I walk into St. Mark's Church in Bestwood Village, and I knew with every fibre of my being, here I am. Here is where I have been promising to be for 32 years. My seed of faith, that apart
from a few weak promises when I had my own adult baptism, because I had to be baptised in those days to get married in my local church. There was a weak promise there. I'm coming back next week. I've really enjoyed the baptism evenings, and I'm going to come back, and I'm going to keep coming back. Then a few more weaker promises at my own children's baptisms, again in Messwood Village. Countless weddings and funerals that I went to, with a parting shot to God. Oh, I'll be back. You see, I never did go back. From those Sally Army days, I was 16 years without. Well, I think I was 16 years with the Spirit of God hovering over me. You see, we have to play our part. We have to water our seed of faith. Coming to church, dwelling in the Word, sitting in prayer, all of that helps our seed of faith to grow. Joining a Bible study so we can study the Word and grow together in our faith, that's watering our seed of faith. The Holy Spirit waits to be invited in. He's like a guest, a very, very important guest. And we all know how we should treat guests that we invite into our bricks and mortar homes. You see, the Spirit can only come on invitation. The Spirit can only come if we invite Him. I believe we have to keep on doing this. We have to invite and then keep inviting, because if we don't, we'll have my 8-year-old scenario. We have to keep that relationship alive. We have to keep the house full, our temple full of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and guided by the Holy Spirit. He wants to come and live in us. And who, including the Holy Spirit, wants to talk to empty walls? So the Spirit doesn't leave us when we've invited Him in. But He can only do the work of the Holy Spirit if we are willing participants. When we open the door, maybe afresh today, I don't know where you are in your journey. Sometimes we get like, we close the door, don't we? We pull the windows, pull the battens down, no more of this. Actually, we have to keep on keeping on. Sometimes our Jesus journey can be a bit blurry. It made me think about when we get all that hissing and shh, when we're trying to find a particular radio channel and it goes, and because we're not fully tuned in, we're not really hearing what God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit is saying to us. You know, I talk about those nudges, don't I? I talk about those funny feelings that you're going to get in the pit of your stomach. That's the Holy Spirit. If you have invited Him in, you will have some jelly in your belly, people. There will be those moments, I can guarantee. Because when we're fully tuned in, when we're listening to what we are being told, what the Holy Spirit is saying to us and for us, with that indwelling, we can have a clearer ear We are on point. It is only with time and prayer and the aid of the Holy Spirit that we begin to see how God might be working for good, even in the midst of what the 2 years we have been through, the terrible, confusing events. And I don't know about you, the aftermath of that as well. How about us taking another breath, right here, right now? And in our mind's eye, as we spend that moment, why don't we invite the Holy Spirit to come into our life? Or come into our life again? Because everything has to have a beginning. And the greatest thing about God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit is that that happens on a daily basis. Spend just a pause. I don't have to hold your breath if you don't want. Let's just pause and let those words of Jesus speak to the deepest part of our hearts, our life, our souls, our fears. When he tells us, "Do not let your heart be troubled. My peace I leave with you. Hand it all over in the pause." My peace I leave with you. Peace begins when we open ourselves up, warts and all to the one who will give us a new beginning each and every day. As Jesus spoke those words, he is one day away from his end. Yet here he is, speaking these words because he wants to help his friends, his disciples, and us today to understand the impact his ending can have on each one of us. Jesus is telling us we can and should have a deeper relationship with him. And now he is going back to the Father. We can, by his Holy Spirit, have a new life, a new beginning in him. Jesus is inviting his followers not to cling to the physical, whatever that may be for us. Here, it was his physical presence, but to be open to a deeper way of being in relationship with him. Often, we find it so hard to let go of things. Sometimes we find it so hard to embrace the new. But in clinging to a past, we are in danger of letting the present become dead to us, to end. Various people, Peter, Thomas, Philip, Judas, who we've heard from this morning, ask for clarification about what Jesus is telling them. They don't know that at this moment in time that Jesus is, he's going to leave them in the physical sense. But as he goes, there will be a new beginning, a place for the Holy Spirit to dwell, within each one of us. The Spirit will lead us into all truth, because that's the Spirit's role, to draw alongside us, to be our advocate, our helper, our comforter, our friend, because that's what good friends do, don't they? They tell us the truth, encouraging us forward. We can begin again with Jesus, and what's more, we can be assured of a good end. Everything has a beginning, and God the Father sent his Son, who in turn sent his Holy Spirit, that anyone, we heard it in our reading this morning, anyone can have a new beginning. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Wendy. It just reminded me, I had a similar experience to you, going to church as a child and then coming back as an adult. And it just brings home to me how important it is that we support our leaders who are with the young people this morning, because that's where the seeds are often sown.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah.
So we're going to stand and sing again in a moment. We're going to sing My Song Is Love Unknown. We've talked a lot about God's love shown in the Gospel of John, and so this is what our hymn will be about next. Please stand if you're able.
and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please be seated. And the prayer for today, the collect for the sixth Sunday of Easter. Risen Christ, by the lakeside you renewed your call to your disciples. Help your church to obey your command and draw the nations to the fire of your love and to the glory of God the Father. Amen. And so we come to our time of prayer. For a world that is broken, Lord, we ask that you would put on the hearts of all the leaders of every nation a desire to do your will and not their own. We pray for a world that would be filled with your love, your peace, and your glory. Receive our prayer. We pray for a community that cares for the other person, a community that feeds the hungry, that cares for those who have little money to live on. Help us to find a way of helping all those with difficult decisions to make.
Receive
our prayer. We pray for all those we know and all those we don't know who are poorly in body, mind, or spirit. We'll just have a moment where you bring to mind those people that you know. And Lord, we ask that you put your healing hand upon them, that they may know you are very near to them, to comfort and to hold them. Receive our prayer. Being made one by the power of the Spirit, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And perhaps just look at one another and share the peace that way this morning. Fantastic. So we're going to sing again in a moment. This is the opportunity for you to bring your offerings forward if you have one that you'd like to donate to the work of St. Paul's. So if you're ready, perhaps you'd like to stand once more as we sing, Lord Jesus Christ, you have come to us.
Oh.
smile together as we prepare our hearts, our minds, every part of who we are to share this very special meal together. As usual, we're still in keeping with coming from the back up to receive the communion in one kind, which is just the way for the moment. If you haven't already come and brought your offering, please do bring it then, and then take your trip and back to your seat. Okay. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Almighty God, good Father to us all, your face is turned towards your world. In love you gave us Jesus, your Son, to rescue us from sin and death. Your word goes out to call us home, to the city where angels sing your praise. We join with them in heaven's song. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of the Father and of Christ, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Father of all, we give you thanks for every gift that comes from heaven. To the darkness, Jesus came as your light, with signs of faith and words of hope. He touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean. This is his story.
This is our song, Hosanna in the highest.
The crowds came out to see your son, yet at the end they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people. This is his story.
This is our song, Hosanna in the highest.
Jesus blessed you, Father, for food. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body given for you all." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, he gave it, and he said, "This is my blood shed for you all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." This is our story.
This is our song, Hosanna in the highest.
Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which he died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again and is alive with you to plead for us and all the world. This is our story.
This is our song, Hosanna in the highest.
Send your Holy Spirit on us now, that by these gifts, that we may feed on Christ with opened eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, where all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. All blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
please do draw near with faith. Think about that invite that God, through Jesus and the Holy Spirit, has for each one of us. Because this invite is for anyone. Please do join in the singing after you have shared in this meal. Save your conversations for coffee time. Please draw near, from the back to the front.
Thank you.
We say our prayer after communion together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and our bodies to be a living sacrifice. Set us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
I'm just going to remind you that those of you who haven't taken out your bundles of newsletters, they are over here in reception. Do have a cup of coffee and biscuit, and then do take your little bundle if you haven't already. Okay, that's the newsletter. There's also our Queen's Jubilee Jamboree activities at St. Paul's. It's all on there. So if you're in danger of forgetting where you should be and when you should be, take one of those and that will remind you. There are plenty out there. For those of you who would like to cast your eyes over the APCM's last year's April's APCM minutes, they are on the board out there. We're not giving them out this morning. They were all passed on Thursday evening. We had the wrong minutes. People, the PCC and people that were here were asked if they would like to continue the meeting. Yes, we continued the meeting. They're on the board. Should anybody like to see them? This is last year's APCM minutes, not a PCC minute. So just to remind you, this is where we nominate church warden, PCC members, deanery, synod member. It's all there in the mix. And there's not very much to an APCM, to be honest, but you are very welcome to cast your eyes over those if you would like to. I've already talked about our Jubilee Jamboree. I'm not going to labour that because it's all on here. I am going to labour, even though it is on here. Sunday, 5th of June at 10 o'clock, we have invited Bishop Andy to our Pentecost service, and Bishop Andy has accepted our invite. So he is coming on Pentecost morning, and he is going to get here about 9:30-ish, and then he's actually going to stay while we have cake and tea and biscuits and whatever else to chat with people. So obviously you are very welcome to chat to Bishop Andy on that morning. And please do wear something red. I keep trying to wear something red to remind you. Pentecost, we'll have our red altar cloth, so please wear something red. Also on that day, I would like to remind you of this too. This is really important. So Sunday the 5th in the afternoon at 3 o'clock, we've got some all-age activities, and that will be all-age activities. And we're going to have some refreshments before we start. It would be great if members of St. Paul's could actually support this, because it's the guides and the brownies that are putting on the afternoon. I asked them to, and I invited them to, and they very kindly accepted the invite. The scouts and et al, they're all off on a Jubilee weekend, but please do come at 3 o'clock for more cake and more tea and coffee. Any other tomorrow notices?
Tomorrow morning meeting.
Tomorrow morning we have a meeting for all those of you. I have tried to remember sending an email out to everyone yesterday. If you put your name in reception area, then please have a look. Remind yourself that you put your name down. We're having a little meeting at 11:30 here in the social area, just to be able for Life Begins on the Thursday, and on the Saturday
as well. So Life Begins is, along with Food and Fellowship, we've got about 70 people on the list. So if your name's not down already, please consider where you can help. So that will be a high tea with tea, coffee, glass of sherry, lots of cake, I would imagine, and we're almost at numbers, to be honest, unless other people put their names down as helpers. So we're going to get our ducks in a row for Thursday and for the Saturday evening as well. So Thursday evening we've got the Fab 2, those of you who have been to a Food and Fellowship or Life Begins will have seen the Fab 2 before. Their Fab 2 are just what they say on the tin. They sing Beatles numbers. So do come along and enjoy that. And then on the Saturday evening, we have got, and his name escapes me at the moment, we've got a very lovely guy who's coming with a keyboard to play for us as well. And there'll be nibbles, sandwiches, okay, and a booklet for you on either one of those. Our faithful queen, remember we had them when it was our servant queen, so they'll be free. Or if you'd like to make a donation to any of those things that I've mentioned previously, then you are more than welcome. I can invite you to do that and you can receive that how you wish. All done? Yeah? Let's sing together then. Let's do it. Praise to the holiest in the high prayer.
Thank you.
May the Lord make his face to shine upon all of us and all those that we love and care for and maybe still haven't seen at this moment in time. The Lord be gracious to each one of us and bring us his peace. And we ask for this blessing in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Please do stay for tea and for coffee. And don't forget to fill in the sign-up sheets, that's in yellow. Thank you. God bless. Thanks, Ray.